Well, we're entering the month of June from where I sit in time. I don't know what time of year, what time of day. It could be that you could be consuming this content, but from where I am filming this video, we're entering the month of June. And of course, that means that we're going into summer in this part of the world. For the majority of the world, we're entering the summer season. And it means a lot of things for a lot of people. It means Father's Day is coming up, which I believe is a global observation and celebration. It means that the kids are getting out of school for summer. It means the 4th of July is coming up if you're an American. It means a lot of different things. It's a very, very good time of year. I love summer, probably my favorite time of year. It's hard to beat fall when the leaves change and you got that homecoming nostalgic sensation and feeling in the months of fall and the season of fall. It's hard to beat that, but it's hard to beat summer. Those extended lengthy days, the sunlight, I love summertime. And June means a lot of things to a lot of people. A lot of people born who live on earth in this month. God brought them into this world in the month of June. The labels that were given to these months were, they go back, dates back, I believe June, I looked it up, goes back to the Roman era. They're the ones who established the organized order of counting days was established that we have embraced and that we accepted. It differs in different areas of this world. June probably isn't June if you go out to China or you go to Iran or, you know, other areas of this world. From where I'm sitting, from where I'm speaking, it's going to be the month of June. And June means a lot of things, and June is a lot of things to a lot of people, primarily an indicator of the summer season that we are entering. However, as we know in contemporary days, June has come to mean something else. And it has been turned into something else and defined as something else and brought to represent something else by some who live in this world. June has come to be labeled as Pride Month. What it is observed as, what it represents, what it indicates, the summer season, etc., and what it has meant traditionally to all of us is not what it has been viewed as in recent years. June has become to be proclaimed as, viewed as, promoted as Pride Month by certain dear souls in this world. And you know what that is? It is a global celebration and observation of perversion, sodomy. For the entirety of this month, a certain movement and a certain group of souls will come together to celebrate and promote sodomy, homosexuality, transgenderism, and all the such. And before I get into this, I want to clarify, I'm not targeting anybody. I'm not speaking about anybody, and I have nobody in mind when I'm bringing this truth to you, and I never do. I never do. I had a dear friend text me recently. I had made a video, and he watches some of these videos that I make, and I had included in that video an illustration of a conversation we had. And he knew, he recognized, he's like, hey, we were talking about that. And he texted me and he said, because I get passionate, and that's just my style, I get passionate. And I'm looking at the devil though. I see Satan and I see Jesus when I'm speaking, and I'm trying to do this effort to serve God. But he texted me and said, you were talking about me, weren't you? And I said, brother, you weren't even on my mind. I'm sorry. And I know it may seem like I never have anybody in mind. Have you ever done this? Have you ever tried to do this? It's like playing Guitar Hero on Expert. You're just trying to pick the words and flow in the spirit. And I'm not targeting anybody. I have nobody in mind, and I never do, other than the devil. I'm just trying my best, to the best of my ability, to present the Word of God to you. I'm not attacking anybody. I'm not isolating anybody. I'm not targeting anybody. But because the devil has brought sin up, as I've said before, the lion, the bear, it must of need be confronted by those who claim to work for God and those who are called and chosen of God to present His Word. And that includes me, believe it or not. But what it is not what it has been in the last few years. June. Over the moon in the month of June. And here we are, the month established goes all the way back to 154 BC. And you could go further back than that. What is a month? But a way of tallying days. A tally of days, a way that we can count and understand and organize the changing in the moon, the changing of the suns, the changing of the seasons, and whereby we can schedule and organize our daily living. go back even further, beyond 154 BC, when apparently the month of June was established by the Roman Empire. It was called Lenius or something like that. June was not what we see it as. It didn't even exist. We established June. And you go back before that, what existed before we created the calendar? Before human beings created the calendar and created a way of tallying and counting days and organizing the count to where we can somehow, other than the gray hair we get and the wrinkles and the fading strength, organized by the moon and the sun, a way of order in that process of time. The Word of God said the evening and the morning were the first day. There were no weeks. It was the first day, the second day, the third day, and the third, fourth, fifth, and then the sixth, and the seventh, God rested. God rested on the seventh day. There was a week of days, and God gave man the wisdom to establish by His order. He established that seven-day week. The count of days, the calendar, the months, in order to indicate and identify and understand the seasons that we can order our life by the calendar. Through the wisdom of God, astronomical observation, mankind organized an order for identifying and defining time. We have January, February in this part of the world. In other parts of the world, you know, their New Year's and their seasonal count differs. But here, from where I speak, and you can translate it to your area of the world, wherever you are, you can interpret it that way. But here in the United States and other areas of the world, we have January, February, March, April, May, June. And that's all come to be out of what was the first day, the evening and the morning, the sun rising, the sun setting, the moon, the stars. What it really is days. And June is a count of a set of days within a year, or what we've established as a year, but years technically don't even really exist other than God giving us the wisdom to be able to tally time and understand time. The Bible said, teach me to number my days. God, give me the wisdom so that I can understand that it's going behind me and that I can organize and order my life in a specific pattern. And that's how these months and these years came to be. God gave us wisdom. Teach me to number my days. They're limited. They're fading. We're fading. We're failing physically. And God gave us wisdom to invent the calendar. June was an invention of men, even though, albeit by what God's invention, God's creation. And if God gave wisdom for that, tremendous, I think it is. But God didn't establish June. Man did. And man did it in a way of organizing and putting into order a way to tally days and years. And from that, friend, we've seen another invention of men. This is a month of fake believe and make believe, and it has become that way because of what men have turned it into in sin. Pride month, in observation and celebration, they've taken what was June, days, sun rising, sun setting, and interpreted it as an end, created it and invented something of it that was not, that never was. Pride month never existed. You go all the way back, like I said, June started in 154, and before that it was just sunrise and sunset, and as far as I know, 154 BC. They did have, obviously, a calendar throughout the ages. That's what we have adopted, our calendar right now that I'm speaking of and from, and translated again to your native land or whatever. But June never was to 154 BC, and now Pride month never was to whenever they established that. That is an invention of men, out of an invention of men to tally days, out of the invention of God, the sun rising, the sun setting, the evening and the morning were the first day. And on the seventh day, God rested a week. But Pride Month never was. Pride Month never was. People created it. People invented it, and they did it out of what was. And now we come to June, and many see it now, unfortunately, in a perverted perspective of reality. They see it as Pride Month, but that never existed. So they've taken that which was, turned it into something it is not, and now people see it as that which it is not. Not all, thankfully, but many now see this time of year, because they've come in, they've changed it. They changed it into something it is not, and people have adopted and accepted that as reality, and it is not reality. It never was. and how appropriate that is to surmise all that is and has become this month to many people. That which was changed into that which is not, and now it is perceived as what is not. But it never was. And if it never was, it never is, and it never will be. It's an invention of fiction, imaginary, fairy tales. It never was. The Word of God says this in the first chapter of the book of Romans. Paul speaking of sin in that area of the world, and the sin of sodomy, just as is the sin celebrated and promoted by many this time of year. Paul said this, "Wherefore God also gave them up to uncleanness through the lust of their own hearts, to dishonor their own bodies between themselves." Speaking of homosexuality. "Who changed the truth of God into a lie and worshipped and served the creature more than the Creator, who is blessed forever. Amen. For this cause God gave them up unto vile affections. For even their women did change the natural use into that which is against nature, a sin against nature. And likewise also the men, leaving the natural use of the woman, burned in their lust one toward another, men with men, working that which is unseemly, unimaginable, inconvenient, doesn't work, and receiving in themselves that recompense of the error which was meet." Receiving in themselves that recompense of error which was meet. That means they're tearing their bodies apart. And part of the judgment of sodomy is partially in the destruction of the flesh that naturally occurs when you violate it to such an extent. Fake believe, make believe, changed, the scripture says. They changed that which was natural. And now they adopted and accepted, and the Bible said God gave them up. They didn't create it. It was not theirs, it never was. God, the Bible says, made them man and woman. God created them male and female. Jesus said, in the beginning, back before 154, back before anybody ever established a title above a count of days and nights. In the beginning, Jesus said, God made them male and female. Apostle John said, that which was from the beginning, we have seen and we have heard. You see, it's not what we make it, it's what it is. And they have taken the colors of the rainbow, redefined and reassigned. They've taken words, redefined, reassigned. They've taken an entire month, redefined, reassigned. And people are adopting and accepting that as legitimate, literal definition and meaning. And it is not. What have they done? They've changed that which was, that which is natural. Not only months and days and years and words and colors. They've taken their own bodies, the Bible says, and changed that which God created, that which is, the way it was, changed it, perverted it, redefined, reassigned, and said, this is what it is. But it never was. It never is. It's a redefinition, and it is not the definition. And the world's playing their games. It's fantasy. It does not exist. No man is a woman. No woman is a man. I'm not trying to anger you. I get passionate, I know. But I love you. Listen to the truth I'm saying. I'm trying to save your soul. I'm trying to save you from the damnation and the hell. The Bible says Sodom and Gomorrah, the smoking ashes of Sodom and Gomorrah, are an example to anybody who would go that way. And Paul says at the end of this first chapter, the book of Romans, he said, knowing the judgment of God, that they which commit such things are worthy of death. The wages of sin is death. I speak of the severity of sin. I've seen the Savior. I felt that fear. And people may say, you shouldn't focus on fear. Wait till you see Him. Jesus said, fear Him who can destroy soul and body in hell. It's a fearful thing to fall into the hands of God. There is a hell. There is an eternal hell. There is a second death coming. There is a lake of fire. There is a place in which the worm dieth not. Paul said, they that commit such things are worthy of death. You talk about the severity of sin. It must be talked about. I'm not better than you. But I'm clinging to that old rugged cross. And I'm daily saying, God, cleanse me. God, forgive me. God, keep me pure. God, keep me. and I'm standing strong in God's unmerited favor, knowing that I am nothing, that I can't do it on my own. But I'm doing my best, lead me not into temptation, to live right. And I'm disciplining my flesh so that when those temptations rise, I'm going to overcome them by the power of God. But the world's playing get their games. Okay, this is what the rainbow means. This is what purple, yellow, blue means. Green, whatever colors are in the rainbow. This is what these words mean. He, him, she, they, them. We're redefining these words. You got to accept that. This is what June means. This is what human anatomy means. We can chop your body up with a knife and change your gender and change your DNA. This is what this means. Who changed the truth of God into a lie. And they're changing truth into a lie. And the world is playing with the lie and embracing the lie. Oh yeah, Pride Month. It doesn't exist. It never existed. Homosexuality is a fantasy. The proof is in the product. Conception is only by heterosexual procreativity. The proof is in the plumbing. You can't take a body part that is meant for exportation and try to import. I'm sorry. You'll tear it up. I had a dear friend who was a homosexual. He was a great man. I loved him. I prayed for him. I witnessed to him. Told him about the love of God. And he came up to me a while ago, back when my mother was yet living, and he told me and my mother, he asked us to pray for him. He was facing a very serious surgery on a particular body part of his that had been severely damaged due to the sin he was in. It's unnatural. Recompense of error in themselves. Female and female, biological, cannot reproduce children. Not only is the devil playing for the future population of humanity, the devil is playing for the present population, and he's trying to damn them to hell. Fake believe, make believe. It doesn't exist. But the world's saying, okay, yeah, that's what it is. Since when? God doesn't have alternate definitions. The colors of the rainbow don't mean anything other than the mercy of God Almighty. They made it up, and the world's acting like it's legitimate. It's not legitimate. It's not real. They've changed the truth of God into a lie. God spoke through the prophet in the Old Testament, the prophet Isaiah, the 44th chapter of his book. He spoke of idolatry and idol worshipers. And he said, you take and you make those idols, in essence. He said, the smith with his tongs will work with coals and fashion with hammers and the strength of his arms. And if he doesn't drink water while he's creating the idol, he gets weak. He said, the carpenter will stretch out his rule and mark a piece of wood with a line. And out of a tree, out of a rock, out of a precious metal, they'll form a god. And then they'll bow down and pray to it. And in essence, what God was saying there was, you made it. And its existence depends on you. That it's not a god. It is not God. It's a creation of your imagination, and you are not the creator. You use my breath, and you were totally dependent upon food and water to do it. You used your strength that I gave you. You had to make it out of what was. The dependency of perversion upon what is to create what is not. You can't just make something that was not already made. Evidence that it never existed, but evidence in what exists is all that exists. If there wasn't the month of June, so to speak, you couldn't have turned it into anything. If there wasn't sunrise and sunsetting, you couldn't have made your own thing out of it. But you can make whatever you want out of it. It is not what you make it. It is what it is, who changed the truth of God into a lie, and that which was from the beginning will be forever. Jesus said, I'm the first, I am the last, I am the beginning and the end. Forever and ever and ever, He is the same, yesterday, today, and forever. And truth never changes. And Jesus said, if we don't praise Him, the rocks will cry out. The rocks will cry out. That which men will bow down and worship, the creation of their hands, they say, that's God. but their God says and does nothing. Change the truth of God into a lie. This is what it is. That is not what it is. It is what it is. We have to go back. In the beginning, Jesus said, God made them male and female. In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. You can try as hard as you will, my friend, to turn it into what you want it to be, what you think it is. It is not. There is a way that seems right unto man, but the end is death. You've got to figure out who created this world, why things function the way that they do, why that there's a demand that we observe the legitimate creation of things, how things work, why they work that way, and where it's all going and where you're going. There is an order, and an order we must submit to, who changed the truth of God into a lie. You can change it, you can redefine it, reassign it. That doesn't change it. That just means you're going to live in a delusion, and deluded state, and a confused state. And I've been confused before. Not my fault, but I've been confused before. I know what it's like, so I empathize. And I pray for you, and I plead with you to stop and look around and consider. You have to at least consider what I'm saying. If there is no God, you can do whatever you want. It doesn't matter. But if there is a God, you, my friend, are in big, big trouble at the end of it all. And let me tell you, my friend, with full assurance, there is a God. There is a God. And God created the heaven and the earth. And God created us male and female. And God created you perfectly. And the devil may try to pervert that perfection. But God says, come unto me, all ye who labor and are heavy laden, and I'll give you rest. I'll make you who you were made to be. I'll embrace you. I'll clean you up. I'll take your sins away. I'll save your soul. God really loves us. There is a God. There is a Savior who died on the cross for you to take your sins away. There is a heaven. There is a hell. There is a way things really are. And you can try to redefine and reassign, and you can be passionate about it. You can cling to it to the very moment of your death, but it doesn't matter. What is always going to win. Who changed the truth of God into a lie. And God, the Bible says, gave them up. He'll let you do whatever you want to do. There's no dictatorship, domination. It's free will. Do what you want. Do whatever you want. God's not going to run in on you. If you don't want anything to do with him, he'll stay away from you. But he'll try again and again and again to prove that his love for you is legitimate, to prove that his existence is truth, so that you may know the truth and the truth will set you free. Embrace a lie, live a lie, you'll die a lie, and you'll die and go to eternal hell, and all liars will have their part in the lake of fire. This is what Satan has always done. Always. Especially as it concerns the Word of God and the things of God. Even in the Garden of Eden, when God said, don't eat of that tree, he came in and challenged what God said and tried to change it. He cannot compete with God, so he must redefine and reassign and change the things that are into what they are not in order to mislead, because he can't compete with it. It's obvious. The heavens declare the glory of God. The sun rises, the sun sets. There is a God. He can't compete with the truth of this word, so he has to turn it into things it is not and have people see that instead of what is. This is what he's so good at. So he takes the colors of the rainbow, reassigns. It's about homosexuality. It's not about the mercy and love of God. It's not about the covenant of God to not judge man again with water that God gave to Noah. And then he takes a month that no doubt speaks of the glory of God or is intended to, and he changes it. Pride month. Pride month. And redefines and reassigns. And then he takes you, a precious man or woman created in the image of God, created and destined for salvation with a great purpose encoded in your soul. And he wants to change you. Who changed the truth of God into a lie. But at the same time, God is seeking to change you as well. But not to change into a lie, but to conform into his image and into the truth. God wants to take those lies, eradicate and erase them, and conform and change you into who you were really made to be. Friend, I'm telling you, there's nothing better than embracing what is, accepting what is, submitting to what is, and allowing what is to produce truth in you and to change and conform you into truth. God wants to take the lie of Satan and change it into the truth of God. Who changed the truth of God into a lie? God wants to take the lies of Satan and change them into truth. It's not Pride Month. It's summer. It's sunshine. It's warm weather. I'm a man. God made me a man. I am a man. I'm fearfully and wonderfully made. God makes no mistake. There is a God. I didn't create this world. I don't get to define everything. I didn't write this word. I don't get to come in here and change definitions. I didn't have the inspiration for the English language. I don't get to redefine those words. It is what it is. It is what it is, and I accept what is. Let God be true and every man a liar. I'm not going to change the truth of God into a lie. I'm going to take the truth of God and embrace it as it is. And let God, the truth, conform me into truth. What it really means, it doesn't mean what the devil says it means. What everything means and what everything says is God loves you. You are fearfully and wonderfully created by God. God made no mistake when He made you. God loves you. God loves you. Yes, He does. And He's extending His hand to you right now to change that lie into the truth and to change your heart into what He created it to be. To change you into the truth that you may be His son, His daughter. That you may be who you were made to be. You are created by God. You are creation. Nature testifies it. Nature declares it. He is the creator. We are the creature. We don't write the rules. We don't define the words. It's His, not ours. He loves you today, my friend. I don't care what sin you committed. Homosexuality, transgenderism are disgusting sins. They are perversions of the mind and the heart. They're illnesses, mental ills, psychological ills, emotional ills. Some people drift into those sins because of neglect and abuse from their parents, parentally. Some men become homosexuals because they strive for and seek the approval and admiration and acceptance of the male gender, a father figure. Because their father was abusive, their father was mean. Some women do the same. Others, sometimes it's because of a relationship that went bad in a heterosexual fashion. And they were so hurt, they said, I'll never be hurt again. So they'll go and be a homosexual. Because their significant other of the other sex, gender, cheated on them and hurt them or abused them. And they say, I'm never going to let that happen again. I don't trust men. Or they're rejected and hurt and abused by men or women heterosexually. They say, I'm not doing that again. Others, it's just downright perversion. The devil changes the truth of God into a lie. They watch pornography. A lot of people get started in homosexuality by consuming pornography. It'll pervert them initially, and the perversion will progress until it turns them into a complete and total pervert, and it will not stop at homosexuality. It'll blend into transgenderism, and unfortunately, pornography is in the majority of entertainment nowadays. Even the music, even the movies. Illicit, explicit. It's not just OnlyFans, it's not just whatever pornographic website you can easily access nowadays. It's everywhere, and everything has pornography in it. But God is merciful, God is just, God is good, God is the truth, and God is seeking to change you and to liberate you by the truth. He loves you, He died for you. There's nothing better than Jesus. There's nothing more valuable. He is worthy. Serve Him. Embrace the way things are. You may lose your friends that are gay. That's fine, man. I'd rather be in a deep, dark grave and know that my poor soul was saved than to live in this world in a house of gold and deny my God and lose my soul. Take this whole world, but give me Jesus. Take this whole world. But give me Jesus. Take this whole world, but give me Jesus. Though none go with me, still I'm going to follow. Though none go with me, they may turn their backs on you. They may not want anything to you, but God's got better friends for you. And there's a friend that sticks closer than a brother. You may have to walk a lonely road, but I'd rather walk alone to heaven than go to hell with a crowd. It's a narrow way. It's the way of truth. And in the end, we win. It's not about this world. There is a death coming. Eternity is coming. Are you following a lie? Did they change the truth of God into a lie? Or are you following truth? Be changed and conformed to the truth today. Today's all we have. Jesus could return today. It's all about now. Jesus loves you. He died for you. Come to Him now. He'll cleanse your heart. He'll take your sins away and make you who you were made to be.